Well, this is not your typical situation, but I want to thank all involved for going the extra mile and giving me this forum to speak. Of course, not being with you tonight in person, I'll not know how you're responding to the presentation. But the upside is, if I bomb, I'll never know. And I'm in Italy. Let me start out by stating, it's been a great ride with so many memorable experiences. After taking a job as a head coach, the first order of business is picking a staff. So I'll start with a story about my staff. In the early years, I was still trying to do some staff bonding while trying to learn them. I would take the staff to a couple of clinics a year. One particular evening after a clinic in Cleveland, we went out on the town. As we were walking, we found a street vendor peddling Italian sausage sandwiches. Of course, I, along with my longtime assistant coach Pat Palumbo, could not possibly pass up Italian sausages, so we stopped to order. Just as we paid the vendor, two cars collided about 15 feet in front of us. The first person jumps out of the car with a bottle, breaks it off, and walks towards the other car. The man in the second car, seeing someone with a broken bottle walking towards him, reaches down, gets out of his car with a gun. I grabbed Pat's arm and yelled, "Let's get out of here." Pat responded with an emphatic, "Wait, I didn't get my sausage sandwich." I learned two things about Pat that night. One, when he commits to something, he's fully committed. And two, this man's willing to die for Italian sausage. I certainly want to thank all of those who advocated for me for this honor. I'm truly touched and honored by your support. I do apologize for not being there with you tonight, for this is not a Terrell Owens play on my part. I'm sure that you understand, my wife has always wanted to go to Italy for some time, and well, I enjoy being married. I want to thank Brad Burst for agreeing to be my presenter tonight. As I write this, I have no idea what he just said, but knowing Brad as I do, I'm sure that he was well prepared, did an outstanding job, and was most likely overly kind in his words. He'll be an outstanding head coach when and if he chooses to be. When one is honored with such an award, it forces him or her to reflect on the journey. I was blessed to have outstanding and loyal coaches who have stayed with me throughout my tenure. Pat, Mike Wozlik, Brad, and Trevor Kilmeyer, who's also a former player, have each served with me for over 20 years, and Pat has shared the journey step by step. I'm very thankful. The bonding attempts must have worked. All of us try to create a family-type program, and what better way to foster family than to have a stable staff made up of long-time assistants. I've also three former players, Jermaine Guys, Tim Brewer, and Lou Oluwadju, all presently helping as well. Who better understands my expectations and philosophy than men who have gone through the program? To have an outstanding group of assistant coaches has made my job easier. I'm grateful to each for their dedication, commitment, and hard work, and I'm flattered by their loyalty. They have taken ownership of the program, and they've made my program our program. So many people have made this possible. I'll start with my parents, Vincent and Rosemary Calo, two incredible guardians. I'm thankful to my father for instilling in me a competitive drive, determination, and perseverance, and to my mother for teaching me love and compassion for others. All lessons have served me well in my coaching. I'm thankful to have a wife, Michelle, who has continued to keep me balanced and to keep a proper perspective on events, in addition to providing incredible team meals. Thanks go to my children, my son Anthony, who both played and coached for me, but has since departed to manage his own program. My daughter Danielle, with her donations and unabashed support. My youngest, Michael, who played for me as well, promotes our program through the Westerville South basketball Twitter account, organizes the alumni tournament, and lives and dies with every jump shot. Thanks to my godson, Dominic Palumbo, who manages the Twitter account along with Michael. I have a brother, Chuck, who is now the patriarch of our family and serves as a great sounding board, and a brother-in-law, Rick, who claims to be the biggest Wildcat fan. I have a support group who would include Ray Dusenberry and Julie Miller, who have been there since the very first game that I coached and have been invaluable. I've served under 5 athletic directors and 6 principals at South, and I'm sincerely grateful to each of them for providing unwavering support through the years. One cannot overvalue the value of a great administration. I certainly want to acknowledge how thankful I am to all of the players that have walked through our program. I have one story that I'll share that sums up quite a bit. I was coaching in the Ohio-Kentucky All-Star game, and on our way to one of the practices, a player from Lakota East said something favorable about me, and Trayvon Jackson responded by half-jokingly saying, "Coach, tell him the only reason that you're here is because of me." I immediately replied, "He's right. Fact of the matter is, the reason that I'm here tonight is because of the efforts of my players. The sacrifices that they have made and their commitment to our core values has been the key to any success that we may have had. I've coached some talented players, including a couple at OSU right now, and some not so talented. But although talent varied from year to year, the effort very rarely did, and I really respect and appreciate that about our guys. Our alumni is awesome, and I can only hope that I've enriched their lives as much as they've enriched mine. Words cannot accurately express the gratitude that I have for them. Many may think it's the championships won that have highlighted my career, but it's rather the day-to-day practices, the journey, and the relationships formed with my players that has been the highlight. I've been rough at times, intense, hard on them, but never demeaning, and I am sure that my players know how much I love and care for them. It's been my honor to coach at my alma mater and coach in such a respected league against so many outstanding programs and coaches. Many of you over the years have taught me lessons. Let me take this opportunity to address the young coaches out there for a moment. My advice is pay attention to the lessons that are out there. Understand who you are and be yourself. Have honorable intentions and stay true to them. The locker room should be a classroom. There should be many lessons taking place in there. Teach them up, make them better, and make sure that you're providing something that translates and will serve them in life. We possess great influence over these young men and women, and we have an obligation to do our best and be at our best every minute of every day for them. Coaching is a great profession, and if you're fortunate to have a long journey as I've had, make sure that you give back to the game and help another coach along the way. Most importantly, I must thank my Lord, Jesus Christ, for He's blessed me with many gifts, as He has with all of us. Our gift back to God is how we use those gifts. I pray that I have pleased my Lord. I certainly could go on and on talking about basketball or my experiences, but I figured that most of you really don't want or need to hear me do so, so you're welcome. However, if any of you wish to share a story or two, give me a call and we'll go out and get a pizza or a sausage sandwich. Again, I wish I were there with you, but I do think it's pretty cool to have my son Anthony accept this honor on my behalf. Thank you and buona notte.